Melody sails for Flossom.
Hello, Flossom people. Welcome to the Salesforce Flossom channel. In this video, we will talk about what are SOQO and DML in plain English. First, we start with the basic concept. SOQO stands for Salesforce Object Query Language, while DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. First, let's see that they both have language in the names. So just like English and German are the languages we use to communicate with human, these two are languages we use to communicate with the system. Then to find out what they do, see the words in front of language. We have query and manipulation. This explains the functions of these two languages. SOQO is used to search the database, and DML is used to change the database. And to use these languages, you have to write specific syntax. The syntax of SOQO looks like this, and we call this an SQO query. The syntax of DML looks like this, and we call this a DML statement. So you can think of these as work orders. You send in an order so the computer can do the work. And I will illustrate this with some animation. Think of your Salesforce org as a library, and the system is the librarian. This librarian has different parts of the mice that control different things and speak different languages. Depending on what you need, you talk to different parts of the mice and issue orders using the language they understand. And in one transaction, you have the limit on how many orders you can issue for each part and how many records you can access or change. This is what we call the government limit, which we will explain more thoroughly in another video. Since there are limits, when you are issuing the orders, always make sure to find the most efficient way to do so. That's it for SOQO and DML. I hope this helps you understand better. If you enjoyed this video, like, subscribe, and turn on notification. Salesforce Flossom, thank you for watching.